slight pothole, it doesn't matter. I'm just going to make an imaginary line to that hitter. Now, a lot of times I got to take catchers and turn them into outfielders because they can hit. The utility infielder has to be a fourth outfielder, fifth outfielder. He's got to be able to do this. So I had to come up with something that was simple that everybody could get. And this was that was the one line drill. But what I do is I tell him, make an imaginary line to the hitter. All right, now just read the ball left or right of that imaginary line. If it's hit to the left of that line, turn left. If it's hit to the right of that line, turn right. Okay, as simple as that. Okay, and because I let my eyes move my feet, if that ball is hit directly at me, I'm gonna have a full turn. Okay, now I've gotta read whether the ball's gonna be forward, at me, or back. But anything that falls in front of me, what is that? That's a base hit. Where's the damage? Behind me. So I gotta make sure I take care of that first, okay? Now, once I make that turn, okay, now I make a read. But see, I've given myself a chance to make a crossover to get depth. And now I've got to change and go to, say the wind blows or the ball spins or it rotates away from me, I have a chance to get direction. But I've got to make sure I get that depth first before I get that direction. And that's how I do it. Imaginary line, off of that line, depending on where the ball's hit, boom. If it's hit right at me, I'm going to have a full turn. If it's hit in the gaps or down the lines, my eyes are going to tell my feet I'm going to be at a 45. When you get depth on that ball, I've got to go to the 45, down the lines, in the gaps, but my eyes are going to be able to move my feet. Does that make sense? That's an easy, Getsy, but it's a, bring your glove, but it's an easy drill. I bring all the outfit, like I said, this is the first 5 minutes of the day. Every day we do this drill for 45 straight days. And we do the same, because I've got to get them to work on doing a quick turn. And the reason why I call it quick turn, most guys call it what? Drop step. Drop steps can get slow. Drop steps get sloppy. Okay, you don't really get depth on a drop step a lot of times. You're more straight across, and then you got to get your depth. So you're getting direction before depth. The ball's going to beat you all the time. So I call it a quick turn because I want to emphasize the quick part. Now in the drill, I'm not going to turn Getsy loose and make him do all the quickness part. But I want you to understand what the drill looks like. You can do it anywhere. You can absolutely do this anywhere. I mean, I could have this little space right here, and I could bring the outfielders up, and we could work from here to that back door, which in Kansas, most of you guys are indoors a lot. You don't have the luxury of going out on days like this. So this little space right here, I was in Tulsa Union High School, and we got this much room to do outfield drills. That's all we can do. There was hitting going over here, infielders over here, catching, receiving with catchers over here, but I had this much space. One line drill, eight of a line. We just work on footwork all the time. All right, now, with that being said, during spring training, I got, 11, 12 outfielders. So we'll split these into two groups so that they get more reps. So I don't have 12 guys doing it in one line. I'll split it into two groups like this. All right, now, everybody comes up, everybody has a baseball, okay? They walk up to the front of the line, they hand me the ball. All right, they get the pre-pitch set up. All right, we start off with going straight back, which is the toughest one for an outfielder to do. He's having to go straight back, that direction, but he's gonna have to look back this one. So we do this over and over and over again because this is the toughest one for an outfielder to do. All right, so we start off, glove side, straight back. All right, so I'll go. Here's a quick turn. Ball's to the glove side. He does a reverse turn. He goes to the back of the line. All right, next guy walks up, flips me the ball. Straight back, go. Straight back, catches the ball, reverse turn. Okay, over and over. Now, obviously this is not as fast as we go, but just for demonstration, we're going through it. All right, now. The one thing that I emphasize with outfielders is what I call finish the play. And finish the play just means shuffle your feet. So everything that we do, ground balls, line drives, fly balls, we finish the play, meaning we have to move our feet to get in a position to make a throw. Because every fly ball is a tag situation. Every ground ball is another extra 90 feet that we've got to come up and throw. All right. So to keep them going and keep them reminded, We don't ever make just a regular catch and come on in. We always move our feet by finishing the play. So in this situation, and all it means is shuffle your feet. So at the end of this play, all right, I'm going to have you go straight back, reverse turn, shuffle your feet before you make the throw. He stops, he shuffles his feet, the play's over, he moves on. I don't allow the next guy to go until after he shuffled his feet, because I want them to get and understand that they have to finish that play. All right, straight back is number one. All right, now we're going to go 45, left side, go. Again, anything that's left side, good shuffle. Anything that's glove side, you're going to have to reverse turn. Straight back, 45, or straight across, you're always going to have a reverse turn on it. Okay? So we'll do that a couple times through the line. All right, now we'll go straight across. Ready? Go. Straight across, reverse turn, shuffles his feet. All right, that's how we finish the play. All right, now, once we get this side done, now we're going to go back, okay, throwing hand side. Ready? Straight back. There's the catch. There's the shuffle. We finish the play. Same thing, 45, shuffles his feet, and the last one, obviously, straight across, shuffles his feet. All right, now, any questions so far? We're all good? Okay, all right, now, another tough play for an outfielder is actually have to turn this way, left side, going straight back, go ahead and turn, now walk through. All right, now, the ball's been hitting us to the left side, but now because of the spin and the wind or whatever it is, now all of a sudden it starts drifting back towards this side, throwing hand side. So anytime you're moving away from the infield, you always turn your back to the infield. Okay? You never front the ball. Because fronting the ball means this. Alright, you're gonna stop, turn towards me, turn towards the infield, and now try to keep your depth and go get that ball. That ball's gonna beat you every time. It's gonna beat you every time. So in this situation, you always want to turn your back to the infield, okay? And the way you do that, the way you turn your back to the infield and get your body to turn quickly is your head. That's what gets your body to turn quick, is your head. Okay, so when you're doing the drill, all right, heads is going to start off this side. I'm going to flip it over here. All right, ready? Go. This nice and easy. Now, he finishes the play by shuffling his feet. Any questions with that? You're all good? You understand? Okay, now.